guessed it, it's this week's top five. Also, we've got an update on one of the league's brightest teams. Florida softball burns up our what's hot. Plus, you've heard the expression, like father, like son? Well, this former Georgia star takes that term to a whole new level. And how about a little access to Hollywood? The life of an SEC football player is headed to the silver screen. We'll take you on location for a first-hand look. And a look back at some of the finest SEC TV moments over the past 14 years. And maybe some, well, that aren't so fine. All that and more, and you know where you are. It's SEC TV, and it starts right now.
Thanks, Tim, and I hate to brag, no I don't, but I gotta tell you that I think that I have the best job in America. Throughout this year, I will be traveling around to all the SEC schools.
You know, that is no way to start off this last show.
Oh, why not? I mean, come on, 14 years you've been working on SEC TV, and that was your first appearance ever on this show back in September of 95.
Boy, that brings back a lot of memories, but that was also about 10, 20 pounds ago, and a couple of kids as well thrown in there. And I will say this, that probably a few gray hairs as well, but I will say it for the last time, welcome to SEC TV. This is our last show of the season and the last show of a 14-year run.
And my co-host, Dave here, has been here for all 500-plus of those shows. So in addition to bringing you the latest from the Southeastern Conference on this show, we're going to take a look back at some of the show's finer moments from the past.
I'm not so sure about shining. Just so you know, they haven't let me see all the stuff they're putting in this show, so to say I'm a little nervous would be an understatement. But there is one thing I do know, is that we've had another bumper crop of national champions in the SEC this season. So let's check them out in our top five. Our first national championship of this past season isn't of the team variety. It's an individual honor, but don't think for a minute that it's any less special. Ole Miss freshman Devin Britton won the national championship in men's singles, the first such title in the program's history. Britton, a baby at just 18 years old, became the youngest player ever to win the national championship.
In what was a very emotional season, the Auburn Tiger men's swimming team capped their year with another Tiger national championship. Auburn head coach Richard Quick was sidelined in December with news that he has an inoperable brain tumor. But the team rallied around their head coach and put together quite a run to the title. And as for Coach Quick, he remains the eternal optimist about his difficult battle with cancer.
After tasting success throughout the early part of the season, the Tennessee Lady Vol track team knew that they had something special cooking. At the SEC Indoor Championships in Kentucky, what was in the recipe? How about a dash of sprints, a pinch of record long distance events, and a sprinkle of some field events? Put it all together and you got yourselves an SEC title. And for dessert, the Lady Vols feasted on the competition at the National Championships for the Lady Vols' second national title in 5 years. Now, how sweet is that?
We've been around a long time here on SEC TV, 14 years to be exact. And the one constant in this great league, Georgia Gym Dog head coach Suzanne Yocklin. The legendary coach has meant much to the sport, not just at Georgia, but across the nation, putting gymnastics on the platform that it deserves. Going into this season, it was known that the 2009 season would be her last. And the gutsy Gym Dogs gave their beloved head coach the perfect send-off, the program's 10th national championship and 5th straight. How's that for a going-away present?
To say that the SEC is good at football is like saying a fish is good at swimming. It's just understood. The run that the SEC is on right now with BCS titles is becoming, shall we say, dominant. 3 in a row and 4 of the last 6. The Florida Gators have 2 of those. And with almost the entire team coming back, they no doubt have their ravenous reptilian eyes set on a third.
Now, Dave, we don't want to leave out another championship that the SEC has. that equestrian dynasty they're building over in Athens.
It's unbelievable. The Georgia equestrian team won their second straight national title and fourth in the seven-year history of the program. Now, that's a pretty impressive showing for the dogs or horses or however you want to look at it.
Well, speaking of impressive animals, let's check out the Gators on the softball diamond. They had a pretty big week.
Oh, yes, they did. And thanks in no small part to senior Allie Gardner, who hit a two-out bottom of the seventh walk-off grand slam that put Florida in their first ever Women's College World Series. Now, I'd say that qualifies as our Southeast Toyota Moment of the Week.
Now, you SEC fans may miss Dave and I over the summer, but that's okay, because you can just head over to secsports.com. They'll have all of your favorite teams, stats, highlights, updates, and more. And even if you look close, you might see our smiling faces there somewhere on that website. But it's all there at secsports.com.
Still to come on SEC TV, the Gator softball team has feasted on their opponents all season. I believe that qualifies for hot. You can find them in our What's Hot. And this former Georgia football star has returned home to Athens, coming back to the family that taught him so much.
Roll over, stay low, roll over the ball.
Brian McClendon's story is next. And the silver screen to your screen. There's a movie in the works about the life of a former star in the SEC. An on-the-set look into Michael Orr's story.
Buy a ToughShed storage building and pick a free accessory. Upgrade your roof, floor, shingles, ventilation, or shelving. But hurry, this offer ends June 30th. ToughShed storage buildings and garages, coast to coast. Call 1-800-BUY-TOUGH or visit ToughShed.com.
I did actually look at a couple other sites, but they kind of seemed like a digital version of a bar.
It just didn't seem to be really effective.
Other dating sites just give you a picture and a paragraph. At eHarmony, we match you with pre-screened singles based on 29 dimensions of compatibility, proven to be the foundation for happy, long-term relationships.
It didn't seem as shallow like some of the other websites.
So that was the beautiful thing about eHarmony, that you can go much deeper.
Experience the eHarmony difference for yourself. Review all your matches for free at eHarmony.com.
ToughShed installs all kinds of garages all year round. But June is the final month to get a free storage building when you buy a ToughShed garage. ToughShed garages and storage buildings coast to coast. To find the store nearest you, call 1-800-BUY-TOUGH or visit ToughShed.com.
Your teams, your network, Fox Sports South.
You know, scientific tests have proven that when you drink Dr. Pepper slowly,
the 23 flavors taste even better. Hey, I get it, because half my life's been in slow motion. Watch this.
Okay, folks, here we go. High ball game. He bows to the doctor. He puts on a 30-footer.
Slower is better.
Are you kidding me?
Trust me. I'm a doctor.
That's a finish, Dr. J, right here.
Millions of fans, 8 decades of history, 20 men's and women's sports, 12 universities, one site brings them all together. SECSports.com. Scores, stats, and live streaming content. Exclusive real-time coverage of SEC championships. SEC fans and SECSports.com. Some things just click.
When it comes to trucks, the difference is built Ford Tough. Grab the wheel and you'll know. The difference starts by being America's number one selling truck for over 32 years. And with F-150 getting EPA estimated 21 miles per gallon, you'll also feel the difference at the pump. So put built Ford Tough to the test and put the difference to work.
Drive the Ford difference home and we'll cover your first three payments. Plus, you'll get 0% financing on a built Ford Tough F-150. Visit your local Ford dealer.
Dave, it'll be great. Oh, listen, a Fox slogan is home team, Fox attitude. What about just change it just a little to home team, Fox worthy? Fox worthy.
I don't think they will go for it.
Oh, sure they will. And think of the side business. We could do books. We could do records. We could do T-shirts. We could do calendars. We could do posters. We could make millions, Dave.
I gotta go do this show. I'll see you later.
Dave, come on, my family would watch. There's a lot of us. We're very procreative. Dave! I'm calling Bradshaw.
Very impressive, Dave. You've worked with some heavy hitters here on SEC TV.
Yeah, I think Jeff Foxworthy would definitely classify in that department. Well, he was kind enough to help us get our third season started off in style. And no, we did not change the slogan of the network for him. Sorry about that, Jeff.
Well, speaking of heavy hitters, there's still a couple of sports deciding national champions as of this week. And no surprise, the SEC is right in the thick of things.
Well, let's get you caught up on the very latest in softball and baseball in this edition of What's Hot.
Blazing a trail through the Women's College World Series in Oklahoma City was the team everybody thought would breeze through to the finals, the Florida Gators. The number one seed in the entire tournament represented the conference well, barreling through the competition with reckless abandon. The Georgia and Alabama softball teams starred too, and in all actuality, were just a few plays away from the finals of the championship. But it was those fighting Gators who lived up to that top seed of theirs, making it through to the championship. Florida met the Washington Huskies in the finals. But unfortunately for the Gators, their dream season ended with a runner-up finish. All in all, it was another terrific season for SEC softball. On the other diamond, in the other tournament, of the 8 teams to make it to the NCAA baseball tournament, 4 teams have moved on to super regional play. And of those 4 teams, 3 are hosting. Now that's definitely hot. After hosting a regional in Oxford, Ole Miss had all it could handle from Western Kentucky, but the Rebs were bailed out by a career-defining pitching performance from Drew Pomeranz to advance. Ole Miss hosts the Virginia Cavaliers this weekend. The next two SEC teams had little trouble dispatching the teams in their regionals to advance to the Super Regional round. The Gainesville Super Regional will have the Gators matching up with Southern Miss. And recent LSU nemesis Rice returns to Baton Rouge to face a hungry Bayou Bengal team itching for a return trip to the CWS. And don't forget Arkansas. They'll face the always tough Florida State Seminoles in Tallahassee. Coming your way next on SEC TV, they say father knows best. And when your father is a Georgia and NFL legend, he's a good guy to learn from. Brian and Willie McClendon's story is headed your way. And don't forget to come back, because you're watching SEC TV.
How about foosball?
That's it. We got it.
Foosball on every AirTran flight.
Gentlemen, you had me at foos. Turns out we're going to have to table foosball. Everyone wants Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi? Oh, that's good.
Wi-Fi from GoGo. Now on AirTran Airways.
It's the best damn sports show, period. We've got the superstar guest.
Do you know the tickle, man?
Countless countdowns.
Send it in, Jerome! Floating in it!
The unbelievable moment. You never know what you're gonna get.
I'm a man! I'm 40! Knock it off!
The party continues every night. It's the best damn sports show, period. Tonight at 11 on Best Damn.
Why a Toyota Tacoma? It's tough. It's got a powerful 236 horsepower V6 engine that can pull up to 6,500 pounds. And an unbustable composite inner bed with steel outer panels. I guess the only thing not tough about the Toyota Tacoma is deciding whether to buy it.
Nothing compares to the Toyota Tacoma, the best-selling compact pickup truck in America. Visit your Toyota dealer today and get $2,200 in total savings on new 09 Tacoma double cab models. Toyota, moving forward.
Saturday morning, Academy Sports and Outdoors brings you great shows featuring some of our region's best outdoor adventures and golf courses. It's award-winning action everyone can enjoy with your one-stop shop for everything your family needs to stay connected to the outdoors. You won't want to miss a minute of the Academy Sports and Outdoors Saturday morning, 8:30 to 10:30, right here on Fox Sports South.
Derek Lowe plays on Sunday Braves on Fox Sports South.
Oh, welcome to SEC TV.
Welcome to SEC TV.
You're watching SEC TV.
Is that great stuff or what? Just a little bit more of the star power that we've attracted over the years here. The late, great Jerry Clower, the Oak Ridge Boys, Meatloaf, all big SEC fans and all contributors to our show.
Well, star power is synonymous with SEC football these days, thanks to a movie being made about the life of Michael Orr, the standout offensive tackle at Ole Miss, recently drafted by the Baltimore Ravens.
Yeah, what a great story. Now, Michael's rags-to-riches story was the focus of a book that is now being made into a movie, with shooting taking place this week right here in Atlanta, Georgia. The film is one that SEC football fans are sure to be very familiar with, and they will certainly enjoy it.
I think it's a really unique mother-son story, and I hadn't seen the female component in a sports movie in that way. Because, you know, football plays a part in the movie, but it's not the main story. The main story is a story of family and the Tuohy family and Michael Orr and kind of what they learn from one another.
I think what's so resonant about this story is how people reached out to help someone, unlikely, but did it anyway, and what great, great result came out of it. I mean, here we are, we'll all be watching Michael Orr in his first season with the Baltimore Ravens, and it's magical.
I could relate to what he's going through as far as with school and being, you know, the biggest kid and feeling like, you know, the outsider, like I'm afraid to talk to them because they may be afraid of me and I don't want to scare them. Or that's how I went through a lot of school.
I got to play a Georgia coach the other day, so hopefully I've represented Georgia well. If not, I'm sure I'll get cut out of the movie. But no, hey, SEC, I give them a lot of love. They suit up and they played hard every Saturday. So hopefully, if we can just get a little bit of the SEC, if we can get a little bit of that Alabama-Auburn intensity out there, I know we've done well.
Now the movie stars Sandra Bullock and Tim McGraw and opens November 20th. Have to get out and see that one.
Yeah, but there are plenty of other football stories going on in the SEC. Dave, our own Courtney Jones caught up with a coach at Georgia who is carrying on a family tradition. Courtney?
Thanks, guys. Football in the SEC is so huge, tens and thousands of fans show up for a scrimmage or the annual G-Day spring game. They just can't get enough of Georgia football, and neither can the McClendons. Brian McClendon was a wide receiver here at the University of Georgia, but now he's gearing up for one of the most challenging roles of his life.
All right, you got to stay low or that arch going to tear your head up. Finish. There you go. Roll over, stay low, roll over the ball.
Run your feet.
Good. Let's go, man. On the hop.
4 years ago, Brian McClendon was running routes for the University of Georgia. Now he's coaching the running backs.
I said, I'm not going to believe anything until I hear from the head man. And then he called me in his office, and then he told me, and I wanted to get up and actually hug him, and almost burst into tears. But it was really, really, really a special moment. The biggest thing was just the shock, and I was like, really?
The shock wore off pretty quickly as reality set in, because Brian was all too familiar with Georgia football. His father, Willie McClendon, paved a path for his son years ago.
My dad, he's my man. He's always been my role model. He's always been the guy I go to if I have a question about anything. And it's been sort of funny because I've been able to follow him in everything he's done. He played here in Georgia, I played here in Georgia. He played with the Chicago Bears, I played with the Chicago Bears. And he came and coached running backs in Georgia. Now I'm coaching running backs.
There are really not too many father-son combination that have really traveled that same path. And it's great to see that your sons can follow that particular path and be successful.
Like father, like son. But this 25-year-old coach brings an immediate infusion of youth to the coaching staff that will be useful in many ways.
You know, when it comes to recruiting, it takes a lot of high energy, it takes a lot of enthusiasm, and it takes a guy who can relate to those guys, and not to say you ever get too old to relate, but I think the younger guys have an easier task of relating to the young people.
Well, he's very conscientious about doing things the correct way the first time, and that in itself, he's very football smart when it comes to the X's and O's of the game. And so with those two qualities, Brian would do very well.
The biggest thing, you're going to see a guy that can talk to his players. They come back, they tell me what they see, and then you're going to see a guy that's going to help try to let them understand, you know, what I'm trying to get across here. So
he's relatable and has a familiarity to dog football that one could only get from years of exposure.
Well, Brian understands the Georgia way. He understands how we want to get things done, and he believes in it, and he's going to be fiercely loyal to his university and to this staff, and he's going to do it the way we know was best.
The Georgia way has been a part of Brian's life for over two decades. It's a UGA connection that is more than skin deep because it's rooted in family and in football. But more importantly, it's a manifestation of a legacy that lives on.
It's going to be something I always want to make my family name proud. And I want to pass that on, of course, to my children and relatives as well as any. But just to be a representation of Georgia, be a representation of my family, I think it's special enough, and it's worth honoring.
Next on SEC TV, 14 years. Over 500 shows, and they've all been perfect, right? Well, not so much. We have the funniest SEC TV moments over the years. Next, you're watching SEC TV.
I'm Justin Case. Say Fado, Justin Case.
I know it's late, but I'm really worried about being able to afford my car insurance.
Well, we can help with affordable rates, low monthly payments, and we're here for you 24/7.
That's just what I needed to hear. Now I can sleep easy tonight.
See, now that's just what I wanted to hear. Safe Auto, just in case.
Safe Auto.
You're watching Fox Sports South.
I think that possibly, maybe I'm falling for you. Yes, there's a chance that I've fallen quite hard over you. I've seen the waters that make your eyes shine. Now I'm shining too. Because of
more bars in more places. AT&T, the best coverage worldwide.
In the SEC, we proudly stand by our numbers. During the 2007-2008 academic year, SEC teams captured 5 national championships, while 8 student athletes were honored as the best in their sport. It was a banner year in the classroom as well, as nearly 50% of our student athletes were named to the SEC Academic Honor Roll. Whatever the arena, our numbers proudly tell the story of the Southeastern Conference. The SEC, our future is now.
West Birmingham, Atlanta, Georgia.
Quaker State wants to know who has the world's worst commute.
You got construction on 75, 285, I-20, 30 miles, 2 hours. There's nothing I love about traffic. Nothing. Gotta be killing my engine.
Tough commute? Then get an oil that goes way beyond industry standards. Quaker State bonds to metal surfaces for 2 times better wear protection. Quaker State, real durable oil. Think yours is the worst? Enter your story now and Jimmy Johnson could drive you to work.
How about foosball?
That's it. We got it.
Foosball on every AirTran flight.
Gentlemen, you had me at foos.
Turns out we're going to have to table foosball. Everyone wants Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi? Oh, that's good.
Wi-Fi from GoGo. Now on AirTran Airways.
Who needs the scripts?
30 seconds to live, people! 30 seconds!
This package needs to get
the
right now.
No.
Dave, no Spider-Man. Come on now. I would have loved to see that. And that was the open for the Emmy-winning 2002 Halloween show. And I got to say, they just never find ways to quit humiliating you.
Well, it's, you know, it's very hard to maintain my dignity over the years here on the show. But somehow I found a way to manage to keep things somewhat sophisticated, as you just saw.
Well, let's keep with that theme there. You know, we've looked back through all the archives, and I'm not exactly sure how to describe this, but here is a look at some highlights over the last 14 years. So just enjoy.
Go ahead.
As we will preview Vanderbilt, it's not a preview, is it? I'm standing in front of the Gorgas House, one of the oldest buildings on this house.
I hope you're not rolling.
Oh, shoot, now it's moving too.
Plenty.
Coach the Heisman Trophy winner. Forgot where I was going.
That wasn't smooth at all.
Special look at our Legends of the Fall segment as we kind of preview, look at, and do kind of...
Thanks, Tim. You know the...
And joining me once again by my side is my Magnumanius.
My who?
It is March. My Magnumanius. She is Knoxville's own Missy Kane. Now, no, one of the first things that I found out in talking with... Three, two. Well, Debbie Smith, certainly something. Take a look at a great Georgia Bulldog player who gave up the fame of the gridiron.
God, Flim.
Smooth. That wasn't smooth.
Leave me with something besides that. Magnanimous.
For Dave Neal, our BMOC, and our entire crew, Tim Brando saying so long. We'll see you again next time here on SEC TV Weekly. That's your keeper right there.
Yes, sir, that was a good one.
Okay.
Now that is good television. You know, my first instinct is to tease you about your hair, kind of a Tom Cruise cocktail effect, but I do have to ask, BMOC?
That'd be the big man on campus. Yeah, I was strutting my stuff back in the day.
I like that. I would expect nothing less.
You know, also, by the way, let me just follow up with the hair thing. That was before I realized that there was hair gel to kind of keep it all
excuses,
in place.
Huh?
But, yeah, that's great. I hate going back over the years, but we did have a lot of fun. No question about it. Now, we want to thank some of the co-hosts over the years, like Tim Brando, Bob Kessling, Larry Conley, Mike Colano, and Missy Kane, as well as SEC Commissioners Roy Kramer and Mike Sly for initiating the show and supporting it over the years.
And we can't forget to thank the thousands of SEC athletes and coaches that we've featured over the years. And thanks to all of those who have shared their stories with us.
Now, just because this show is going away, don't think for a minute we won't continue covering the conference, bringing you great original programming. As always, we will still have great SEC content.
Well, I think it's time to get out of here, so I'll let you take us home.
Oh, thank you very much. Enjoyed the year, by the way. Thank you for being
Same
a part of the
you.
Show. So, for Courtney Jones, Natalie Taylor, and the rest of our exceptional crew, I'm Dave Neal saying so long, everybody, and I hope to see you somewhere down that SEC road.
This man who's very...
God.
Leonardo has some...
Who?
I'm gonna look.